Okay, so this is the Workhorse 3D printer right here. And the neat thing about this machine is it uses lead screw on all three axes. Okay, so you have your typical Acme lead screw on the Z axis. It's got two Acme lead screws, which has two motor ports. But then it's got two X axis motors, which have to be in sync, and a Y axis motor that's also lead screw driven. Okay, so it's lead screw all the way around. The X and the Y lead screw is a IGES high helix lead screw that has a 50 millimeter lead. So it travels pretty fast per revolution, okay? So you have a lot of distance right here. So we went on this journey making this machine, and we tried out different electronics boards with different firmware, you know, Marlin firmware, RepDA. We tried different smoothieware and different boards with smoothieware on it. So they all had their pros and cons. Now we finally finished our journey when we came to the Duet Wifi. Everything seems to work. Now the way this works is if you look at the firmware right here. So this is the Duet Wifi interface. So if I go down to settings and go down to config.g, what you'll see is this M584. Okay, so when we map the drivers, we're using the X as 0 and 3. Okay, so we're actually using the U axis, or we're making the U axis 3, and it's mirroring the X. So we have this M584, it maps this out, and focus on the X being the 0 and the 3. Okay, now our end stops also reflect this. Now we had some trouble at first. One of the issues we had was the x-axis homing correctly. Okay, everything moved properly, and seeing steps per millimeter, everything was fine. Didn't really have any trouble with the lead screws being seen, except when we homed it out. We ran into a little issue where it would be kind of offset, like it was homing out. One was faster than the other. Okay, it was kind of weird. So, I ran into Tony at MRF 2018, and pretty much what he had me do was on the config.g file right here. Now, originally, the M584 was a little bit further down, okay, in the config.g file. So, right now, the M584 is currently up here, okay. Now, if you were to look at the old firmware, what you would see is the M584 is actually down further before it identifies the actual end stops configuration. Okay? And let's also take a look at the homex.g file. Okay? So, the way this works is basically, you know, it lifts up in the Z, you know, to prevent any kind of crashes or anything like that for clearance. Then it moves the x-axis to the end stop. So basically, we're doing a linear feed with the X moving back minus 605 and a U, which is the second lead screw, moving back U minus 605 at 1500 feed rate. Okay, so what it would do is it would move both of these to X minus 605, right? So what would happen is it would go back, it would move to 605, go back a few millimeters, so we have a G01, S2, X5, U5, then it would slowly move the x-axis once again for a second pass. Okay, so then you got the M584, identifies as the X and the 3, so it basically it joins the U and the X again.